Hello, I'm Jyoti Sharma and you're watching Agribusiness News powered by FTB Organic. Let's start with the latest agribusiness updates. JK Tyre and Industries has lined up a capex plan of about 200 crore for the current fiscal, which will largely be spent on maintenance and debottlenecking of all its plants. JK Tyre Chief Financial Officer Sanjeev Agarwal said, "During FY2020, we expect to spend 100 crore as maintenance capex and another 150 crore to 200 crore will be incurred on debottlenecking of plants over a period of 2 years to increase our operational efficiency." UPL Limited cordially invites for a virtual press meet to share the success of Prunit Groundnut Project in Gujarat, a pioneering initiative for the welfare and prosperity of the farmers, and to discuss plans for the upcoming season. This event will take place on 26th May at 11 a.m. Mr. Sami Tandon, Regional Head of Essence, UPL Limited, and Mr. Ashish Toba, Regional Director, India, UPL Limited, will address the media. India and Israel have signed a 3-year joint work program till 2023 with an aim to enhance cooperation in the field of agriculture. Agriculture Minister Narendra Singh Tomar said, "So far, 4 such joint work programs has been successfully completed. India and Israel have had bilateral relations since 1993 in the agriculture sector. This is the 5th Indo-Israel Agriculture Action Plan. So far, we have successfully completed 4 action plans." Still, India has contributed to Pune Platform for COVID-19 Response, PPCR, anchored at Maharat Chamber of Commerce, Industries and Agriculture under Mission Vayu. The Crop Care Federation of India has sought intervention of Union Minister of Agriculture and Farmer Welfare Narendra Singh Tomar to control the import of agrochemicals to India. In a letter to Tomar, the Federation stated that the import of agrochemicals has increased from Rs 9,096 crore to Rs 12,418 crore, reflecting a growth of 37% in 2019 to 2020 and 2020 to 2021. Harish Mehta, Senior Advisor, CCFI, wrote in the letter to the Minister, "Imports are growing much faster than exports, draining out valuable foreign exchange, surge in imports for non-essential agrochemicals, mainly by traders for resale and by MNCs as ready-made formulations is increasing over the years with an needs to be stopped." IKI Pumps along with its German associates Wissemann and Homa has brought medical equipment worth 1 crore which includes ventilators and PP to Tamil Nadu. From Germany, Kanishka Arumugam, company CEO, IKI Pumps has recently met the Honorable Chief Minister of Tamil Nadu, Mr. M.K. Stalin, and gave the letter of intent to support COVID relief efforts in Tamil Nadu, India. The Toyota Motor Corporation launched a new support service that aims to improve agriculture productivity and make way for intelligent soil cultivation. Furthermore, it would provide real-time visualization of soil components that make diagnosis of soil characteristics an improvement. For more Agri updates, keep watching Krishi Jagran. Thank you.